Hello student, good afternoon student, good afternoon class 6 student. How is your preparation? Do more preparation, prepare yourself every day. Do more practice so that you can get more marks. Have you any problem? Then tell me. Understand? Student, do you hear me? Now look at today I will discuss the some of the lessons which is very important. Revision. The two chapters revision already done today. Now the chapters from knowing the numbers. Knowing numbers. So this chapter is very important. Is very important. So what should you know about this? What type of numbers are there? What are their features and how it is used? So in case of now we have to know two type of numbers, natural numbers, that is 1, 2, 3 dot dot dot. Three dots mean there is no end of natural numbers. The whole numbers 0, 1, 2, 3. So 0 is not a natural number. Natural number starts from 1. So this is very important. There is no end of natural numbers and also there is no end of whole numbers. With 0, natural number starts with 1. So do you understand? Give me response. Do you understand? Next, I will discuss some of the properties of natural numbers. Is very important and whole numbers very important. Like whole number, property of whole number, features of whole number. Whenever we add two whole numbers, suppose two whole number 2 plus 3, then again we add, change order. Order, but add value never change. It is done in both the cases. Also multiplication is done, then you see that in both the cases you get this one get 5 and here you get 6. So here you multiply 2 with 3, you get 6. 3 multiplied with 2, you get 6. So if you change the order, even the value never change. Product never change. Here product never change. Even you change order. And this law is called commutative law. commutative. Commutative law. So this law is called commutative law. So do you understand? This law is called commutative law. Now next, look at whenever you change your order, the value never change. In case of addition, in case of multiplication. But in case of subtraction, I think it is not possible. Suppose you take two numbers, A equal to 2, B equal to 3. Now write first A minus B. What is the value? 2 minus 3. So it is get minus 1. If you get B minus A, change the order, then 3 minus 2 equal to 1. So A minus B is not equal to V minus A. So this law never apply in case of subtraction. Because this is not a number, this is integer. But we need whole numbers. But we get integer. So integer is not needed. Not a whole number. Integer is not a whole number. Integer with negative sign. So integer with negative sign is not a whole number. So put in your mind, this law is not satisfied in case of subtraction. Next, I will discuss some of the math. Look at associative law. That is called associative law of addition and multiply of whole number. So look at, suppose you take A plus B plus C, again you take A plus B plus C, then you get the same result. How? Suppose you take A equal to 1, B equal to 2, C equal to 3, then put 1 plus 2 plus 3 equal to, you get here 1 plus 2 plus 3. So what should you get here? 1 plus 5. Here I get 2 and 3, 3 plus 3. So in both the cases you get answer 6. So order of addition can change, but result cannot change. So in that case we apply the associative law. So do you understand? Yes. Now in case of multiplication, look at, in case of multiplication, 2 into 1, let's 1 into, first you write A into B into C equal to A into B into C. So you get A mean 1 into 2 into 3 equal to 1 into 2 into 3. So first write 1 into 2, 3 is 6 equal to, first write here 2 into 3 equal to 6. In every case you get 6. So this law is satisfied. This law is satisfied in case of multiplication of whole number. So this is very important. We must have the idea about it. So do you understand? Have you any problem? No problem. So try to understand. Exam is at the door. So you must have practice more so that you can get more marks. This is associative law. Associative law. So do you understand, student? Tell me, have you any problem? Do you understand? Yes, next. Some law also apply in case of zero property. So zero property, do you know? Suppose you take a number A. A is a whole number. A equal to suppose 2. Now A multiplied with 0. That means 2 multiplied with 0. So what should you get? 0. So this is the process that when you multiply any number with 0, when you multiply any number with 0, you get 0. So put in your mind, this is very important. Whenever you multiply any number with 0, you get 0. But in case of addition, that is done in case of multiply. But in case of add, look at a number A plus 0 equal to A. That means 2 plus 0 equal to 2. So when we add 0 with a number we never get 0. We never get 0. The number unchanged. So put in your mind, whenever you add 0 with a number, you get the number. When you add 0 with a number, you get only the number but never 0. So that is why 0 is called the additive identity. So 0 is called additive identity. 0 is called additive identity. Because whenever you add 0 with a number, you again get the number. That means number become identified. That is why whenever you add 0 with a number, you get the 0 number unchanged. 0 never comes. But in case of multiply, it is not the same answer. Whenever multiply any number with 0, you get the 0. Never get the number. So this is very important. Put in your mind. Try to understand the matter. Have you any problem? Tell me. So be serious. Do your task. And try to understand the matter. Zero property. Now two law I will discuss. One is a distributive law. Distributive law of multiplication over addition. This is a law. Suppose you get a number A into B plus C. So what should you get? A into B plus A into C. This is the distributed law. That means A is distributed in both the terms. That is why you get A into B plus A into C. And in case of subtraction, A into B minus C equal to A into B minus A into C. Suppose it is given AB plus AC. So what should you do? Take the common A and you get B plus C. So from here to here you can get, again you get back this way. Also in case of AB minus AC equal to, take common A, B minus C. So in this way you can find out the distributed law of multiplication over addition. So over addition also and over subtraction also, both the case there are many problems come and you can easily solve this problem. I will give you some problem, look at. Now try to understand this one. Now I will give you some problem, look at. Suppose you say that multiplied 8489 with 9. So what should you do? 489. Now 9 change. 9 equal to 10 minus 1. So write 10 minus 1. Now 489 multiplied with 10 minus 489 multiplied with 1. Formula applied, A into B minus C equal to AB minus AC. This formula is applied. So write 4890 minus 489. Now subtract it, 9110, 0, 4, 4. So in such way you can get the answer. So in such type of math you can have the idea. Also sometime here plus come. So in that case you apply plus sign and do the calculation easily. So this type of math based on this formula. So this formula is very important. Suppose you try to get 2 into 3 plus 5. So what should you get? 2 into 3 plus 2 into 5 equal to 2 3 is 6 plus 2 5 is 10 equal to 16. So 16 is a whole number. And also natural number. So this type of law is applicable both in whole and natural number. So this type of law you can use in both whole number and in natural number. So don't worry. There is a question come. How many numbers are there in between 248 and 365? So what should you do? Answer. 365 minus 248 minus 1. So no, 17 minus 1. So what is there? 116. Suppose it is told that between 8 to 10. So 10 minus 8 minus 1. So 10 minus 8 means 2, 2 minus 1. That is 1. That is the number come 9. So in such a way you can get the answer. Understand? Have you any problem? Tell me. So in such a way, how many numbers are come in between two numbers, you can easily find out. How many numbers come in between two numbers? So this is the process. Write the numbers, find out the sub value, and then subtract one from it, and subtract one from it. Understand? Now again I will discuss some of the process. That is, a figure is given. Suppose it is such a figure is given. That is A, B, C. Now find out the angles D and E. Name all angles. So angle's name is given in such a way, suppose it is given POQ. So write POQ in such a way, the midpoint always come in the middle. So in such a way you can name the angle if it is the angle given in such a way. So put in your mind. So write the name starting from O, then BOD, BOD, comma, D, B, O, D, no, B, A, D, sorry, B, A, D, D, A, E, again, E, A, C, again, B, A, C, again, B, A, E, B, A, E, again, C, A, D, but D, A, C, D, A, C. In such a way, you can get many angles. A, B, D, A, B, D, angle A, C, D. In such a way, you can get many angles. Understand? So try to understand this one. Have you any problem? Tell me. The next. Again, I tell you about this one. This one is the line. No definite value. No end point. No end point. Has length. But no breadth. So this is a line. So any line you can name PQ, and you write in such a PQ, this one. So in this way you can express a line. Understand? Now next, line segment. Suppose AMN. Definite value like 2 centimeter, 5.6 centimeter, definite value have it. Number 2, 2 end point, number 3, it has length. So this is called the line segment. It is a part of a line. Suppose you take line. Now take M and N. Now wrap this one. You get a definite value. This one M. So in this way you can get the value. Understand? Do you understand? So next, ray in such a you can draw PQ, in such a you can draw AB. So these are the ray. It has one endpoint. Number 2, it has length. But no breadth. So for example, whenever you draw angles, you get this one 0. Suppose this one A, this one B. So OA and OB rays make an angle AOB. So in this way you can have the idea about the whenever two, this one cuboid, so this one is the line, segment, you can find out in a cuboid, these are line segment. A point, anything you can write point, this is point. It has a position. It has no length or breadth. Number one, number two, number three. It has a location. So in a plane, that is plane. You can draw any point outside also P, Q, PQHA, exterior point. A, B, interior point. AB, PQ in outside the plane and AB inside the plane. So put in your mind which is come inside, that is interior, which is come outside, that is out exterior. Now next, these are the main things you can find out, many math easily. How many million make 1 crore? If such type of question come, what should you do? How many million make 1 crore? So write million, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, 100,000. Now, million. So, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, and crore. So, we take again zero. Now, put comma after it. After three digit. So, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million. Answer it. $10 million. Because once, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, and crore. In such a you can find out. This is 1 crore. Now change into Indian internal system. That is Indian system. And this is international. Only changing the position of comma. But you must have the idea about both the place well, chat. So in such a way you can do it. So write it down. Have you any problem? Tell me. Look at the board. Once change this one. Write a even prime and a odd prime number. Odd prime. So how do you do? Write even prime. Answer is 2. 2 is even prime. Odd prime. Odd prime. How do you get odd prime? Prime and odd. So odd is 3 and a 3. So write 3. Odd prime. So in such way you can get 1 not prime not composite. 1 is a natural number. 1 number. Natural number, whole number, and also integers. So this type of characteristics you have, natural, whole and integers. So put in your mind. Twin prime, both are prime, number 1, number 2, difference equal to 2, suppose 5, 7. 3, 5, 11, 13, and also consecutive. CUNACCUTIBE, consecutive numbers. Twin prime, co-prime, CF equal to 1. HCF equal to 1. Suppose 36, 25. Look at this pair. 25 divide 36. 1 ya 25. Again 25 divide. Look at HCF equal to 1. So do more practice for the theory test. Goodbye, student.